Question number 3. 2 protons, P and Q, move with the same speed, meaning the speed of the VQ and VP is same value in a uniform magnetic field B. At a certain moment, the direction of their velocity, ratio and figure, so the proton P is with speed VP and proton Q with the speed VQ. Describe the subsequent motion of each proton. Justify your answer. If you look at the diagram here, so the direction of the V, speed of the proton P is parallel to the direction of magnetic field B. So if you know, if you look at the left hand, so here's your thumb is the force, and the first finger is a direction of the magnetic field B, and your second finger is a speed or we can use a currents, speed of the current V. And so if the equation to calculate the force acts on the particle P, the force here is given to the magnetic force FB is equal to QVB sine theta. And the theta is the angle between V and B. So if the direction of the VP and the B is a parallel, this is parallel, B is to the right, and also the direction of the VP to the right, so meaning the theta is equal to 0. So sine theta is sine theta, 0 is equal to 0. So meaning the magnetic force acts on the particle P is equal to 0, meaning the particle P continue moving straight line. But for the particle Q or proton Q, the direction of the V or speed is to the downward, and direction of the B here is to the right. So meaning the angle here is 90 degree. So if you look at the equation here, so now the theta here is equal to 90 degree for the particle Q or proton Q. So meaning the FB, you can calculate the FB for the Q here. FB here for the particle Q is a QVB sine 90 degree, or sine 90 is equal to 1. So meaning you have the force between force on the particle Q, meaning the direction of the particle or proton Q is not continuing moving to the straight line, but Q is moving to the circular part, right? So this is a circular part because this is if you use the left hand, so direction of the B is to the right, and direction of the V to downward, and the force here is out of page. So meaning the this is out of page. So the path of the motion of particle Q or proton Q in the circular parts, not continue to straight line compared to the proton P, because of proton Q have a magnetic force acts on it. Number 3, a bin of hydrogen contains isotope hydrogen 1, and this is hydrogen 2. The bin enter velocity consists of 0.2 tesla magnetic field and 2.5 exponent 5 volt per meter electric field. Ion that mesh from the velocity selector enter the region's magnetic field 0.3 tesla uniform magnetic. Okay, so after leaving the velocity selector, calculate the velocity of the ions. So as you know, the this number one, the velocity of the ions for the these systems, when the ion hydrogen ions in the 0.2 magnetic field and 2.5 exponent 5 electric field. So you can relate the velocity in the system. You can find the value of the V by use the value of electric field of the system and divided by magnetic field B in the system. So you have the, like say this is a positive plate, right? And it's negative plate. So this is electric field between the two plate E, and you have a magnetic field between the two plate. If you have the positive charge, this is hydrogen, let's say hydrogen, positive charge, enter to the region B, and electric field E, so you have the two force X on the positive charge when enter the this area. The first force is a magnetic force, and the second force is come from the E, FE. But the value of the FB is equal to FE. FB is given by the equation QVP, and the electric force is equal to Q times E, electric field. This is magnitude of a charge. Now you can cancel the value of Q left, right, and now you have a V is equal to E over V is, now you have a V is equal to E over B. So this is a equation that you can find the value of velocity of the ions in the system have a magnetic field and the electric field E. Now the value of the E is equal to 2.5 exponent 5, and the value of the B is 0.2 Tesla. Now you can find the value of the V here. V is a 1.25 exponent 6 meter per second. Okay, number 2. Radius of the semicircular parts of the each ion. Number 2, after the leaving the velocity selector, meaning the after leaving the velocity selector, so now you don't have the magnetic field X on the system, meaning the for number 2 you have a magnetic field B, and you have a ions, hydrogens. This is the positive, right? And positive for the hydrogen 1, and this is for the hydrogen 2, right? So say this is the first and second. So when enter the when the ion merge from the velocity selector, enter a region of 0.3. So now the regions here for the B is 0.3 Tesla. As you know, when the particle or positive charge, positive particle enter to the regions B, the particle have a force X on it. So the force magnetic field or magnetic force X on the particle here is equal to QVB, and the direction or the path of the positive charge here is not the straight line but the semicircular path. And you can find the radius of the semicircular part here by using the equation or related equation between magnetic force B, and this is a circular part, meaning you can refer to the circular motion or centripetal force FC. Now the FB is equal to FC. FB is a charge times speed times magnetic field B is equal to centripetal force is a mv squared divided by R. So now you can cancel for value for V here, and you have the value of R is equal to mass divided by magnetic charge and magnetic field B. So now you have a radius for them, because you have two ions here. So ion first, this is a hydrogen 1 and hydrogen 2. So you have the for the hydrogen 1, and the second is radius for the hydrogen 2, and the same equation m divided by qb. Sorry, this is not the m, because we cancel v, and this is v square, meaning you have a v here and v here, so mv divided by qb. And for the r1 or for the radius for hydrogen 1, so the mass of the hydrogen 1 is a 6.67 exponent minus 27, and the speed here is this is come from answer number 1.25 exponent 6, and the charge of the particle here is equal to the value of the charge. This is hydrogen, this is actually this is a the value of charge here is a 1.6 exponent minus 19. This is equal to charge of proton. So this is hydrogen 1 is a proton charge. And the same the B is now 0.3 Tesla. This is for the R1. And same process R2, the mass of the hydrogen 2 is 334 minus 27, and the V is the same value, 125 exponent 6, and the charge is the same value to the charge for the hydrogen 1 is 1.6 exponent minus 19, and the B is the same value, because the region of 0.3 Tesla uniform magnetic field. And now you can find the value of the R1 is equal to 0.043 meter, and for the R2 you can use the calculator, is 0.086 meter. So this is the radius for the hydrogen 1 ion and hydrogen 2.